Hello guys, Adam here. Did I mention that I like the DigiSpark very much? And today in this video we're gonna get max of our DigiSpark by using actually max chips. So max chips, max 7219 are part of this LED 8x8 modules. You can buy them in Chinese shops. There's a plenty of them. For example, a set of four costs something like $3 or maybe less of that. And we're gonna use a DigiSpark, and actually this DigiSpark is kind of different than the one that I showed in my previous video. So this one has a actually socket instead of USB plug. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna construct the LED scrolling text banner. I have prepared many versions for you, so this one actually is scrolling from left, from right to left. I have also scrolling from left to right for some other languages like Arabic. So there's a plenty of choice. Also, you can upload the text over the USB from the PC, or if USB is not working, because I'm using a DigiCDC library which is not working well under Windows 10, but it works perfectly well under Windows 7 and Linux. So the other version is the using a soft serial library, and for this you need a kind of a USB to serial converter. So this one is a FTDI 232, and this will allow you to upload the text to be displayed on this daisy-chained MAX 7219 modules. Will allow you to upload it from the PC or from the mobile phone, and then completely disconnect the DigiSpark from the PC, and it will perform then a standalone operation. Of course, every text that you upload will be stored in non-volatile memory, the EEPROM of the DigiSpark. So let's get started with the code. You can buy these MAX 7219 modules right here on, for example, AliExpress shop. So as you can see, the price is something like $4 per four modules. So they are sold in set of four, and you can even choose the color of it. Okay, let's go further. So on my GitHub page, which is here, you can find a set of source codes. These are INO files, so the one for Arduino. For two of them are working with the serial USB to serial port adapter, so this one and this one. And next two are only for USB, and as I mentioned, USB is not working well under Windows 10. So currently I'm using Windows 10 at this very moment, and I will show you how it works with the serial port adapter. Okay, somewhat about the connectivity. I have two schematics here. So first one is, this one is for USB to serial port version. So you have to attach RX and TX connections to 3 and 4 pins. Of course, we'll be using two USBs on the PC. So first one will be for powering this DigiSpark, and the second one would be for uploading the text, which can be 500 characters long, because this is the amount of the non-volatile memory in the 8085, the chip that is inside the DigiSpark. And the second version of schematic is the one without the serial converter. So this one works only under Windows 7 or under Linux, any type of Linuxes, because they have a driver built in for the DigiSpark. Okay, so when you purchase a FTDI converter or any other USB to serial port converter, you have to install the drivers. For FTDI, this is a page to download the drivers. And if it is connected to the Windows, you will see a USB serial converter and USB serial port, the virtual one. And let's get to the source code. So in the source code, I have Arduino running here. In the source code, the only thing you may want to change is the brightness of the display. So it is under the intensity. right here in the code. I have put, I believe, value 1 instead of 8. 8 is the max. I have put 1 just simply to not overload the video. And you're gonna see that in the moment. And let's now upload the code. So as you can see, I have serial port converter put here to my hub. I have two few USB ports in this laptop. So let's now upload this, and in a second I will show you how to upload the text to the device. So I would need put the terminal, because we would like to connect to. Yeah, I have also connect the USB port to upload. So hold on, it asks me to upload the sketch. Now I will connect USB. So it is now connected and it will upload the code in a second. Okay, it's uploaded. As you can see, the text is already scrolling. This is some text that I have previously loaded, but let's now change it to the different one. To do that, we have to connect to the COM3 in my case, the one that is under Device Manager. So you've seen that here. Let's now configure PATTY terminal to connect to COM3. Let's open this. Simply put open. Okay. And now we can put press the keys and it will upload every character that you put to the non-volatile EEPROM memory. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 spaces. Then let's make a text. This is a great video. Please upload more of these to YouTube. Oops, I made some typos. Anyway, and then when you press enter, it will upload the text to the device, and then you have it already displaying. And what else we can do? We can detach the device from the PC, for example, like. Actually displaying all the text from the memory. So when I switch this one off and I connect it to the USB power bank, you will see that it has all stored and it will display it from the memory. Okay, so that was the first version that was operating with the USB to serial port converter. And now let's switch to the Linux to show you how the USB upload works. Okay. Okay, let's see now how the USB version works. And I have one right here. So the only difference is that we are using a DGCDC library instead of soft serial. And as you can see here, I have disconnected this USB to serial port converter. It's not needed anymore. We'll be using only single USB connection. To program and upload the text to be displayed in the device. So let's now upload this. It's compiling and I will have to connect the DigiSpark. So it should not now upload the new version of program. I have cleared the data, so it is now not displaying anything, just to not to introduce any issues. And we run the PATTY, so you may run it as an administrator, but it's not really necessary. So let's wait a second after it runs, and then what you need to configure is to put a correct serial port name here. So this is the one that is used for DGCDC library. The speed is not relevant. Simply open. And then we may put another text. So let's make it like this. Now spaces and then This is USB version of Arduino DigiSpark LED banner. Awesome device. And no spaces, just to have a fluent scroll. As I mentioned, I also have a reverse version, so that is prepared for guys from different countries, from Middle East. They may want to put Arabic characters, and let's now upload this one. Let's see how it is working. I must admit that I don't have a definition for Arabic characters. I have only Persian one, and for Persian language there is a some portion copied and pasted into the script. You may test it. Now we are uploading the reverse version, and now it is uploaded and it will scroll from the end to the beginning. So this is the one that many guys from Middle East are looking for on the internet, and I have made it for them. Okay guys, so I hope you enjoyed this video. This was a little weekend project for you, and if you liked, please press the like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much, bye bye, and hope to see you again. Bye.